Attention Walmart shoppers, there is a chance your picture could be on a website called peopleofwalmart.com. Well, the website features pictures of Walmart shoppers across the country along with less than flattering comments about them. One woman says she's angry she cannot remove a photo of her dear old mom wearing a trench coat from the site, which has the caption, quote, "a Canadian member of the division of the trench coat mafia," end quote. But did peopleofwalmart.com break any laws? Joining me now, civil litigation attorney Keith Sullivan and trial attorney Brett Nomberg. Good to see you both.
Thank you.
All right, Brett,
yep.
There's no expectation of privacy in a public place, and Walmart is the most public of places.
It certainly is. I mean, and, you know, looking at the photograph, she wasn't wearing anything terrible anyway. I mean, I've seen some terrible people wearing some terrible stuff in Walmart. This was not it. There's nothing wrong with somebody taking a picture and putting it up on the internet. I mean, you're in a public place. What did they expect recently?
Yeah. All right. Melanie Wheeler is the woman who got her knickers in a bunch over this whole thing. She said to a Michigan television, let's put it up on the screen, quote, "If I take a picture of somebody in public, they're in public. My argument is, you're in a Walmart. We have no privacy rights." Melanie, listen to me carefully. No, you don't. Now, Keith, you might take issue with that.
I disagree. You are correct that it is a public place and you have no privacy rights. But what happened here is a tort, and it was illegal. It is the tort of appropriation. It's using someone else's image and likeness for profit or commercial enterprise. What they're doing by posting these photos on the website is they're driving an enormous amount of traffic to the website, and they have a link labeled "advertise with us." So they are soliciting other businesses to advertise on their site, and they are gaining by putting up those photographs there.
Brett, you buy that?
Well, that law was meant for when, back in the day, if somebody took a photograph of you in a pair of jeans and it's just one newspaper article and it's up and you're trying to get money off of that person. This is where, you know, they're taking a picture of not just this person. There are hundreds and thousands of people whose pictures are up there. So who's to say where the profit's coming from? This one picture of this woman wearing a coat or all the other pictures? So there's no real damages here. There's nothing that could possibly be provable on that point.
I'll tell you what's embarrassing, Keith. Melanie Wheeler admits she was a fan of the site until suddenly... You know, she saw her mom, then it wasn't so funny. I mean, that's a little bit like a bully who thinks it's funny until he's bullied.
That's what happens to them. That's what's interesting here, is that's the only reason she came across her mom's picture. She was on there laughing at other people and then realized it was happening to her family by being out there. But they're certainly gaining. They even created an iPhone application. Interestingly enough, they changed the name from Friends of Walmart to Feature Creatures because they said they were afraid Walmart would come after them. Reality is they did that because iPhones, the Apple company, is very diligent in ensuring that people don't use these false appropriations.
Yeah, you know, we all go through life doing embarrassing, dumb things. We get caught, sometimes in public, sometimes not. And, you know, to get bent out of shape over something like this, I wore a trench coat to work today, walked into a CVS wearing it. I wasn't embarrassed. Come on, Melanie, get over it. I want to say thanks to Brett Nomberg and Keith Sullivan. Interesting subject, though.
I like Walmart, if it helps.
I love Walmart. And Target. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.